Hello everyone and welcome to this video. My name is Christopher Grabowski, Technical Marketing Engineer with Cisco Systems. Today I would like to show you one of the ways you can integrate SecureX with your Cisco Secure Firewall installation. You'll see how to remediate an IP address in real time with SecureX Orchestration, updating dynamic object directly on the Firewall Management Center. Effectively, this gives you an ability to block an IP address in real time as soon as you realize a malicious activity. Let's start with a high-level overview. Cisco SecureX simplifies detection and investigation of security threats. In the environment, you most likely have a firewall protecting your network. Imagine you notice something suspicious in your logs and you start your investigation. As powerful as the firewall or any other security system is on its own, it has visibility and focus limited to its own domain. Looking solely at the firewall logs gives you limited or single-sided understanding of the context around the security incident. In your network, you might have a few other security systems that gathered information in parallel. There might be some vital observables about the incident that should be taken into consideration. Now, here is the catch. The more systems you have, more data is available, but you need much more time and effort to reach and interpret this information. And this is where SecureX brings its value. SecureX is an extended detection and response solution that gathers context from every corner of the environment. It integrates with over 70 Cisco and other vendor systems, consolidating context into a single view, easy to explore and act on. In this video, I'll show you three features of SecureX that will help you with your day-to-day job. First, the threat response module to investigate a malware event reported by Cisco Secure Firewall. Then I'll use orchestration module to run an automated remediation workflow. The workflow updates a dynamic object in the firewall and blocks the infected host in real time without the need to edit or deploy the policy. Lastly, I'll demonstrate how the workflow could be triggered from any web page using SecureX Ribbon. Now let's see how it works step by step. First, you configure your firewall policy using dynamic objects. Dynamic objects allow you to add and remove IP addresses from your firewall rules in real time. In this example, we'll have two dynamic objects configured in the firewall policy to block remediated IPs. These objects will be manipulated directly by SecureX as we trigger the orchestration workflows. Orchestration is a SecureX module that allows you to automate administrative or remediation tasks. SecureX comes with a set of predefined workflows provided by Cisco, which you can use out of the box. You can also easily configure your own workflows with SecureX Orchestration low/no-code interface. Here is how a workflow looks like in SecureX. In the center of the interface, you will see a sequence of building blocks that represent actions triggered by SecureX one by one. You can import and modify an existing workflow or create your own from scratch. The interface is designed to be extremely simple and intuitive to use. On the left-hand side, you'll find a set of predefined building blocks called atomic actions, which you can simply drag and drop to your workflow. On the right, you can edit global properties of the workflow. For example, you can set the response category, which allows this workflow to be triggered from SecureX pivot menus. You can also define the input values for the workflow, as well as specify how SecureX reaches your firewall management center, which is actually one of the important design aspects. Think about it. SecureX is a cloud-provided XDR solution, whereas your firewall management center is usually deployed on-prem. By principle, we don't allow direct access from the internet to your management network on-prem. So, how can SecureX reach your FMC securely? We actually have two ways to sort out this puzzle and establish a secure communication channel between SecureX and the on-premises FMC. The first one requires you to install a lightweight connector close to your FMC. This connector is called SecureX Orchestration Remote, or SXO, and will open an outbound connection from your network to SecureX. SecureX uses this connector as a proxy to contact your on-prem FMC. The second, much easier way is to use Security Service Exchange, or SSE for short. SSE is a service living in cloud, providing device, Cisco services, and event management. To use Security Services Exchange as a proxy for SecureX, you just need your FMC to have access to the internet and also link your smart account in the SSE interface. The next SecureX feature is the Threat Response module. The main goal of the threat response is to aggregate cyber intelligence from various sources into a single interface. You can integrate close to 20 Cisco security products, including Secure Endpoint, Secure Network Analytics, Secure Web Appliance, and more. As of today, there are also 54 integration modules for non-Cisco security products, like Radware DDoS, VirusTotal, or Splunk, to name a few. With the threat response, a security incident is visualized in intuitive and configurable graph. You'll be presented with the whole context around your incident, enriched with observables pulled from integrated systems. As you analyze your incident in threat response, you can run an automated action directly from the interface using the pivot menu. This is one of the ways to trigger a SecureX orchestration workflow. In our example, we'll block the IP address of the suspicious host on all firewalls in the deployment. Upon running, you immediately see a confirmation if the workflow was successful. The orchestration workflows can also be triggered from the SecureX Ribbon, which is available out of the box in most Cisco security products. This means that you could run the same remediation workflow or any other workflow, not only from the threat response interface, but also directly from other consoles like Firewall Management Center, Secure Endpoint, or Cisco Defense Orchestrator. The great news is that the Ribbon is also available as a plugin form factor in Chrome and Firefox browsers. This gives you a contextual access to SecureX features from any web page displayed in your browser. In this example, you can see the ribbon stretching Cisco DNA Center interface, providing SecureX context and actions even without the native ribbon support. The ribbon plugin extracts observables from the page and allows you to act upon them. In our case, we can trigger an orchestration workflow to instantaneously change firewall policy. You can use the ribbon plugin on any third-party product web page like Splunk, Radware, or any other site in the internet that provides security observables. Now let's switch gears and have a look at the demo. I'll start with showing you the SecureX orchestration interface and the workflow that will update the dynamic objects for us. Then you'll see the firewall policy configuration with dynamic objects. After that, I'll generate a sample malware event and present how to cross-launch from DFMC to SecureX threat response. Lastly, I'll trigger workflows directly from SecureX, as well as using the Ribbon Firefox plugin.
Here we are in the SecureX orchestration user interface. I created two remediation workflows, one to add an IP address to a remediation object in the firewall policy, and the second one to revert the remediation. If we look inside, you'll see the category set to response. This activates this workflow to be available in SecureX pivot menu. Once the response flag is selected, you may use observable variables in your workflow. These are IP addresses, domain or file hashes, that can be passed to the workflow module directly from SecureX console or SecureX Ribbon. In the workflow, I use the Cisco-provided building block to manipulate a dynamic object in my FMC on-premises. This atomic action will take the IP address we got from SecureX as the observable and add it to a dynamic object I pre-configured on my FMC. Now on the FMC, I have this dynamic object called SecureX Remediation DO, which will be updated by the orchestration module. Now if we switch over to the access control policy, you'll see that this object is being used to block any communication to and from the remediated IP addresses. Now I'll use an ICAR test file to simulate a malware attack. We can see the firewall detected a malicious file. You could continue to investigate this event over here in the FMC interface, but having SecureX, you have an option to see this attack in a much wider context. With two clicks, you can cross-launch to SecureX Threat Response and see a graphical representation of this event enriched with observables from the other systems. In the relationship graph, you can easily understand what are the IPs, hostnames, and files associated with the attack. It is easy to notice the victim also downloaded one more malware from the same server. There are also 12 other malicious files reported to be pushed by the ICAR server. You can also see the URL used to download the malware. At this time, you might be confident enough that you want to protect your network from the server as soon as possible. So let's see how quickly the remediation workflow can help you with that. I'll open a real-time ping to see the effect. And in the threat response, I'll click on this little check mark next to the IP address of the ICAR server to open the pivot menu. Here you can see the two workflows I showed you earlier in the orchestration module. They are visible here because I set the response flag in the workflow category. When I run the workflow, the IP address of the ICAR server will be passed over as the input observable variable. Let's run it and see how quickly the firewall picks up the change. It took roughly 3 seconds, which is pretty fast. If we switch to the FMC, you'll notice the IP address of the ICAR server is now mapped to the SecureX dynamic object. Now I'll use the second workflow to revert the remediation. And again, the update propagates to the firewall in roughly 3 seconds, which is a pretty good score. On the FMC, the SecureX remediation object is empty again. Next, I want to show you how to run the workflow from any web page with the SecureX ribbon. The ribbon plugin is already installed in my Firefox browser. Here I have a sample web page providing a list of malicious IP addresses observed in US. I'll just pick one address and see if it's reachable from my network. Now, with just a few clicks, I can open the ribbon, and as you can see, the IP address is already scrubbed and available to trigger a workflow. We can imagine a scenario where, shortly after blocking the IP address, someone drops an email requesting to restore the connectivity. Well, and guess what? You can get the ribbon to scrub the IP address directly from your email and revert the remediation without leaving the webmail interface. Most of the Cisco security products have the SecureX ribbon available as part of the user interface. The native ribbon gives you quick access to SecureX casebook and the incidents without leaving the FMC interface. You can easily cross-launch to integrated applications and check a reputation of an IP address, domain, or a file hash. I'll put a sample IP address in the observable search bar, and as you can see, the pivot menu is available here, allowing me to trigger a remediation workflow. Let's check the dynamic object. The remediated IP is already here. Now let's quickly revert remediation with the native ribbon. As the IP address is displayed on the page, it is already scrubbed by the SecureX ribbon as an observable. And with two more clicks, voila, the remediation object is empty again. Lastly, I want to show you how to audit and troubleshoot the workflow runs. In the SecureX orchestration, you'll find a Runs and Systems Monitor tab. Here you can find all the instances where a workflow was run. You can check the status, timestamp, as well as the user who triggered the workflow. The really cool stuff is inside. Here you can see a detailed backtrace of the workflow run, giving you a powerful toolset to troubleshoot and improve. Let's have a closer look. The one I'm showing you here is the backtrace of a remediation revert I did using native ribbon in the FMC a few minutes back. The IP address I typed in the observable search bar has been passed over to this workflow as the observable value. You can also see the observable type is set to IP. The workflow was executed on the RTP4 FMC7.2. The observables in the pivot menu could be also domain or file hashes. So in the first step of the workflow, I want to confirm the provided observable is an IP address. In the next step, you can see the observable is copied to a local variable. The workflow has to access Firewall Management Center's REST API interface. Therefore, first we need to authenticate and get a token for further requests. Next, the workflow reads the current list of IP mappings associated with the dynamic object in the FMC. As you can see at the time of running this workflow, the IP address of 172.16.34.100 was already mapped to the SecureX Remediation DO dynamic object. In the next step, we have a condition confirming the IP address we want to remove from remediation is indeed mapped to dynamic object. Finally, the orchestration sends a request to the FMC to remove the 172.16.34.100 IP address from the dynamic object. Lastly, we return a success code. As you can see on the example of the simple yet powerful workflow, SecureX makes it pretty straightforward to create and troubleshoot your own workflows.
Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope the remediation use case you've just seen encourages you to try SecureX integration with Cisco Secure Firewall. Thanks again and see you next time.